Championship Wrestling Saturday night. Only on TBS. Tony Schiavone, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and me and Gene Okerlund as we head towards the biggest one of them all, Halloween Havoc. Exclusively on pay-per-view, and of course, the potential end forever of Hulk Hogan's wrestling career as he puts it all on the line in a steel cage against the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Time for the Hollywood Bomb. Time for Stunning Steve. I should read the sign for the fans, I know.
Stunning, yeah, because they can't print.
Stunning Steve, boy, that's a very determined look on the face of the former champ.
Well, sure, he was jobbed.
He was jobbed.
Yeah. He'll get it back. It's just a matter of time.
Yeah, Stunning Steve, he'll just say he slipped on a banana peel. From the neutral position now, Stunning Steve. No denying his ability. I mean, you're talking about a man who was television champion, world tag team champion, U.S. champion. He has literally done it all. We've said it so many times, side headlock.
You realize what the fans are in for, Tony? You realize what they're in for? They're going to get to see Muhammad Ali. They're going to get to see a list of stars, I imagine. They're going to get to see Hulk Hogan. And they're going to get to see his career come to an end. I mean, what a great night that's going to be.
Well, there's a knee to the midsection.
And Ric Flair becoming world champion for the 12th or 13th time.
That should very well happen. Look at the aggressiveness of Stunning Steve. And we anticipated this. Very angry about what happened at Fall Brawl, about Hacksaw Jim Duggan becoming the United States heavyweight champion.
Well, he should be. I mean, let's make it simple. What if the Chicago Bears had worked all week to play the Atlanta Falcons, and all of a sudden they find out the Atlanta Falcons are sick, and Green Bay shows up? They're not prepared to play them. Same thing happened to Stunning Steve. Mick Bockwinkel did a number on it. On paper, believe me, it's not fair. It's not fair at all.
One of the keys to Stunning Steve Austin and his success in the sport has been his great execution. Much like a Nature Boy Ric Flair, and yeah, the attitude like a Nature Boy Ric Flair as well. Look at Frankie Lancaster going to the knee. But Austin, a man who certainly deserves a world title shot. The number one contender, of course, of the world title now is Vader, who won that triangle match thanks to the masked man. Side of the head, so apparently...
See, the masked man does not work for Ric Flair.
Oh, yes, the masked man does.
Well, what has Flair got to do with Vader? I mean, the masked... I don't know who the guy is.
I think it's very obvious that, you know, one of Flair's arch enemies is Sting. Well, so he's taking out personal vendettas is what Flair's trying to do.
Oh, like
that's exactly what's going on.
Oh, that's
and we can
sure.
argue this point all the time. And we probably will. Was he holding the top rope?
So the masked man basically is like a hitman.
For Ric Flair. I believe that.
And you also believe that I'm working this scam with my neck. And you've even talked to my doctors, and they've told you I'm injured. But no, you don't think Hogan did it. You think I slipped on a bar of soap in the shower or something.
Yes, I do. I don't believe Hulk did it. I believe you.
Well, I don't take showers. I don't mean I don't take showers. I mean, it didn't happen in the shower. Of course I take showers. I take three a day, but it's not under your business.
Side of the head.
Boy, Austin's different. He's really... Look at the energy level he's got. Look at the mean streak in him. I don't think he cares if he gets disqualified or anything. He's going to let everybody here at WCW know that he means business.
And WCW means business. Going on tour. Hulkamania is on tour in Salt Lake, in Anaheim, head first, and in Oakland, California. The 14th, 15th, and 16th of October will be in the Delta Center. We'll be at the Convention Center in Anaheim and the Oakland Coliseum Arena. So we'll have more about that in the weeks to come here on TBS. A hook now by Stunning Steve. Boy, a very focused Stunning Steve. Up, over the top. Runs him in, rolls him up. Frankie Lancaster, great move. Two count. Stunning Steve rolling out of the way. Look at him going to the knee of Frankie Lancaster.
He knows what he's doing. He's got a plan.
Not kidding, he does.
Look at that. Look at the energy level in this man.
Standing reverse figure four. It's called That's a Wrap. And it's on Frankie Lancaster. It may not be long.
Break it. Break it. Break it. I don't mean break the hole. I mean break the knee.
Yeah. Break the knee of a young up-and-coming star like Frankie Lancaster for what?
For nothing. No, rush anymore. He's got two knees.
Stunning Steve, your winner. He's making his way over to talk to Mean Gene. But before we do, this is our Maximum Carnage Move of the Week, Brain.
Well, I don't doubt you on that. Better get a wheelbarrow for Lancaster. He slaps him in and he's not going anyplace. And just look at the determination on Stunning Steve. This man is focused. This man means business. Break it, I told you. Snap it. Snap it.
Spider-Man and Venom and Maximum Carnage. From acclaim for Super NES and Sega Genesis, it's our Move of the Week, and we go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you have just seen him in action. I think a lot of frustration is coming out from this man, Stunning Steve Austin, after what happened last Sunday night at Fall Brawl. Your world kind of fell apart.
Frustration's not the word, Gene Okerlund. I was scheduled to wrestle Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Steamboat walked down the aisle with the belt in his hands in street clothes. Said his back was hurt. Couldn't wrestle, so they handed me the belt. Well, let me tell Ricky Steamboat something. I don't think you're hurt one bit. I think you played the smart guy, because I told him all along what I was going to do. Ricky Steamboat, you got a yellow streak down your back. Mick Bockwinkle comes out of the blue, says I've got a match with Hacksaw Jim Duggan. If the Washington Redskins show up to play the Dallas Cowboys, but the Dallas Cowboys aren't there to play, you can't substitute another NFL team. That's the same with Stunning Steve Austin. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, I don't know who calls you the number one contender. But after I got finished being baited by Ricky Steamboat, molested and harassed by Mick Bockwinkle, who's the former heavyweight champion himself, if I grab Mick Bockwinkle, what's going to happen? Oh, they're going to find me a whole paycheck. What does he do? I'm trying to get out of the ring.
He gets suspended.
Collect my thoughts. Here's Mickey Bockwinkle sitting me across the ring with all his might. Wham! Jim Duggan, big football tackle. I'm counting the lights, and the referee's counting to three. No way, Jim Duggan. At Halloween Havoc, I want you. Oh, I want that match with Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Because that's the biggest travesty in all of professional wrestling.
Here's a man that is not a very happy camper right now. The problem with his speech, too. Sunny Steve Austin. There's more Saturday night when we come back. Don't go away.